I am a physician and a brain health researcher. Brain health at its best represents an optimal state of physical, social, emotional, and mental function sustained by continuous development and activity of the human brain. But I have lived with all of you through the last almost 3 years of the worst event in our collective brain health, the COVID-19 pandemic. Over 24 million individuals in this country alone suffer from a long-term consequence of COVID-19 infection called brain fog. And in trying to understand brain fog, picture with me an experience of actually trying to drive through the fog produced by the weather. It's all around you. It slows you down and reduces your focus. You can't go forward too quickly in any direction because you might hit something. It's frustratingly intangible, but overwhelmingly present. And when we think about the symptoms reported by individuals who suffer from actual brain fog from COVID-19, we hear things that include, I can't find the right words. I can't remember simple things that used to come naturally to me. Sometimes the fear sets in and people ask questions like, I'm in my 20s. Am I getting Alzheimer's disease? What is happening to me? I'm going to explain what results in COVID-19 brain fog, and I'm also going to talk about how boosting our brain health is one of the most powerful ways to solve this feared complication from the virus. And in understanding brain health, we have to note that it is based on factors that each and every one of us has the ability to modify. And the reason that's important is because in my lab, we've actually studied one of these factors, body tissue fat. And we note that body tissue fat, as it goes up, reduces brain health. And we studied this at the brain's equivalent of a telecommunications network, the white matter, one of the two main types of tissue in the brain, the other being the gray matter that houses neurons, the functional units of all we do in the brain function. And white matter, we see in these beautiful colors illustrated here, connects different parts of gray matter, allowing for optimal communication and function. What we see with body tissue fat is, as the physical size of body fat goes up, the strength of these brain connections goes down, worse in men than in women. So by relating our understanding of brain health to populations at risk and noting that these are modifiable factors, we have a powerful way to sustain our ability to optimally function as we get older and move through life. Unfortunately, during the COVID-19 pandemic in the early weeks, there was a complete shutdown of all human subject participant research. And so I couldn't study brain health factors. But COVID-19 was everywhere in the public mind and discussion. And I was approached by the media to comment on a specific case of what was thought to be the earliest known example of COVID-19 actually resulting in brain damage in this country. We're looking at an example of what that case looks like on an MRI scan of the brain. We have a normal example of a brain MRI, but in the COVID-19 individual, we see a dramatically abnormal high signal and swelling in the central part of the brain outlined by the arrows called the thalamus, which is responsible for tracking all of the sensory inputs that come into our brain. Now, when asked by the media what my reaction was to this case, all I could say is, we need a lot more research to understand how COVID-19 affects the human brain. But how do you do research when all of your human participants' research has been completely shut down to stop the spread of the infection? What I and my colleagues did was go back to the medical literature to identify any published report we could find locally, nationally, and globally to understand how COVID-19 could affect the brain. And we then summarized that information into an article that attempted to make a conceptual framework for how COVID-19 affects the brain. What we're seeing here is a figure from that paper illustrating how COVID-19 causes brain damage in the short term. COVID-19 gets into the brain through the nose and induces an immune response that damages the olfactory nerve, which controls our sense of smell. This is why so many individuals who suffer from COVID-19 complain of either a loss or diminished sense of smell. But there's a lot more that happens after that in many individuals. COVID-19 creates an exaggerated immune response, leading to a massive release of small molecules called cytokines, which trigger a runaway freight train of inflammation that leads to catastrophic consequences elsewhere in the brain, including strokes, clots in the large veins, and meningitis. We published this paper only 3 months into the pandemic phase in this country, in June of 2020. But even at that point, we speculated that there would be long-term consequences of COVID-19 on damaging mental and cognitive function, even if individuals did not have these short-term consequences. And little did we know, a process that we thought would take years to understand became apparent very rapidly. Because as research restarted with the advent of the vaccine, we saw more studies being done on human participants to understand how COVID-19 could cause other types of brain damage. One of the most impressive studies in this area was one examining 400 individuals with COVID-19 in the United Kingdom compared to around the same number who did not have an infection. And using high-resolution brain MRI scans, they compared the physical size of brain volumes. Now, volume is a vital sign for the brain. When it is normal, that means that neurons in the gray matter are functioning at their very optimal state. But when volumes are low, that means that neurons are either shrinking or dying. And this can create deficits in cognitive and mental functions. And we're seeing the results of that study displayed on a template brain showing these gold and red colors. But these gold and red colors actually illustrate a poverty of volume, a loss of volume or shrinkage in individuals with COVID-19 compared to those who did not have the viral infection. And the areas that are targeted, the frontal lobes, the temporal and parietal areas, these are the same regions that, when abnormal or damaged, can lead to the brain fog symptoms of lost attention, reduced memory, diminished focus, as well as word-finding difficulty. We know that the symptoms of COVID-19 brain fog can last for years, as shown in a study examining over 300,000 individuals. So we know that COVID-19 creates brain fog by diminishing brain health. So what are some steps that we can take to actually reduce this complication? One of the most important ways is vaccination. In one study of over 13 million individuals, it was found that vaccination prior to having an infection reduced the risk of future COVID-19 brain fog symptoms by 15%. So if you're not vaccinated, it is critical to become vaccinated. And if you're already vaccinated, it is as critical to become boosted. But there are other steps we can take to strengthen our brain health and reduce the rate of COVID-19 brain fog. One method is to lower the reservoir of inflammation in our bodies by reducing the amount of body fat. And the simplest way to approach this initially is to take the most unhealthy choice you can think of in your diet and substitute it with a known brain-healthy choice. And in our research, what we found and published on is that consumption of omega-3-rich fish, as little as once per week, relates to larger brain volumes compared to individuals who don't consume fish regularly once a week, in the same areas of the brain that are responsible for memory, learning, attention, and that are also affected by COVID-19 brain fog. Another step we can take to improve our brain health is to simply, literally take more steps. Now, we've all heard that taking 10,000 steps a day is optimal for physical health. But what if I were to tell you that you could achieve the brain health benefits of taking steps with as little as 3,000 steps a day? Comes out to little over a mile a day, which in one study of over 78,000 individuals was found to be best achieved by walking little over 100 steps in just 30 minutes. It's much easier than we think. COVID-19 attacks the brain and causes brain fog by reducing brain health. But if we individually invest and take ownership into our own brain health and support this effort as an overall society, we could reduce the burden of the complication of COVID-19 that I most fear. Thank you.